So I've been experimenting with Roblox's new Studio Assistant that I believe they created about 2 weeks ago. And one of the features that this assistant provides that piqued my interest was the ability to generate materials using its generative AI to add these custom decorative materials into your game if you decide to do that just by simply asking it the question of generating a material, and the assistant will do it exactly for you. Now, I'm making this video because I did something that I should not have done. I basically went too overboard with this generative AI feature that actually resulted in me getting moderated from Roblox because of my attempt to generate material. So if you want to know how I got to that point, you should stick around till the end of this video so that you can understand what I've done and what you should not do when you're using the new Roblox Studio Assistant. So in the beginning, I asked it a very harmless question just by asking, can you generate a golden material for me? And the AI was happy enough to create variants of plastic described as quote unquote golden and has a regular pattern. So the AI created four of these patterns for me, like this one. If I click on it, then it'll apply it to this part right here. And I can even change some other properties of it, like the studs per tile, to make it zoom in or out. And I can even change the pattern as well to make it organic or non-organic. And I can switch around with these different materials to see which one I like the most. And that's pretty cool. This is a really robust, really cool generative AI feature that this assistant provides. And I encourage you to try and use this in your game to figure out what material will fit best when you're building your Roblox game and developing it. So I was like, okay, I asked it a pretty basic question, but I got the results that I wanted. Let's see how specific I can get with this generative AI feature. So the next question I asked was a little spicy. I asked, can you generate a material of YouTube? And as you know, YouTube is a company, and I don't think you can just throw around materials that represent another company. So I was really interested to see what this AI had to offer. So if we scroll down, it generated four materials that sort of resembled YouTube in a way. We have this one, which I think it looks pretty cool. You just have some sort of off-branding looking YouTube logo. And you have this one, which I don't think even loads properly. Then you got this one, which I don't even know what the heck this is supposed to be. And then we got this one, which I think this design's actually pretty cool as well. This is probably my second favorite out of the ones that we've seen from here. So I was like, okay, I was able to generate something that resembled another company. So now the question was, how far can I really go with this generative AI? Now, again, up until this point, I do not encourage you to try and do this because this is a very, very risky thing that I was just doing, and I do not encourage you to try and do this on your own. I just want you to learn from my mistake. So with that being said, the next question I asked was, can you generate a material of memes? And this one generated three of them that sort of relate to memes, but I was thinking when I asked, can you generate a material of memes, this would be specifically memes that we would probably see in pop culture, but it's basically just a whole bunch of random stuff with impact font and just some random jargon that I don't even know what the text says. We got this one, which doesn't even load, and then we got this one, which again just is filled with a bunch of stuff that I don't even know what the heck is about. These ones were pretty tame. I mean, the YouTube and the memes one were a bit spicier than the golden material that I was asking for, but at this point, the question I asked afterwards, I sort of got very, very carried away with. I'm not gonna lie to you. And this is actually what resulted in me getting moderated on Roblox. Again, like, I do not encourage you to do what I did. What I did was pretty stupid, but I just wanted to show you that these things can happen. And if these things do happen, then you should try and give feedback to the AI assistant, because it's still very new and you need to be able to teach it to know what it can generate and what it cannot, because this is still a very new feature. But anyways, now getting into the real spicy question that I asked it, which was, can you generate a material of Breaking Bad? And literally, bro, like, it said creating variants of plastic described as the lab and has a regular pattern. And I don't even want to show these images because, bro, like, these depictions, these are, like, actually really, really bad for Roblox standards. Unless if this was like a 17 plus game, I'm not sure if you're allowed to. But bro, I can't believe the generative AI actually created these images that for the most part are not allowed to be shown inside of a Roblox game. And this is what got me moderated because I asked this question and there was no way of reversing my question that I asked it because it already generated the materials. And for whatever reason, I just asked it one more question of, can you generate a material of Star Wars? And it literally generated three materials that resemble clone troopers and whatever this one is. I don't know the names of these, but bro, this AI assistant, it can get you banned real fast. Like, you need to be very careful with using this AI assistant, which is why I'm making this video. It's to heavily emphasize that you need to be careful when using the AI assistant to make it do things that you want it to. Because right now, it's an untrained model that needs reference from everybody who's asking it these questions. And so we've come to the moderation page. Now, this was on my main account, so this was extremely risky for me to do. And once again, I can't emphasize this enough. Do not attempt to abuse the assistant with its AI, with its generative AI. So I got a warning here saying that Roblox does not permit illegal or regulated content in any form. This can include alcohol, drugs, tobacco products, or bomb or weapon making. And this reason was for illegal and regulated content. So thankfully this was a warning, but take note of my mistake to not do this. It's extremely, extremely risky, and it's just not worth trying to generate AI that either abuses the Roblox terms of service or copies intellectual property from something from someone else. So this was just a warning, and I thankfully can reactivate my account, but this is just letting everyone know that this is something that you should be very, 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 very cautious about. Do not try and do something stupid with this AI generation feature. And I think that's pretty much all I'm gonna say about the Roblox Studio Assistant. So with that being said, I'm gonna end the video here. And one last thing I want to add is I do not want to fearmonger anyone from not using the AI assistant. It is very important that we do tell the AI assistant what's right to generate and what's wrong to generate. So I'm not encouraging you to just never use the assistant ever again. That's not the reason why I'm making this video. I just wanna bring awareness to the capabilities you have with the assistant. And I still encourage you to try using the assistant so that we can all make the assistant a better feature when it comes out of beta. If there's something you ask it and it generates something that you know is just wrong and it's something that's not ethically correct, then you can give it feedback by either liking it or disliking the response that the AI has given. So if possible, you should use its feedback feature to make it a much better system for the future. So I wanted to emphasize that. I'm not trying to stray you away from using the AI assistant. If you want to use it and you find it helpful, then I want you to be aware of the possibilities of using this. If you want to look at another new feature that Roblox has added and that I made a video on, I encourage you to watch my unreliable remote events video that I made a couple days back. It's a very interesting video that I think you'll learn a lot from. So with that being said, I'm gonna leave it here. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope to see you in the next one. Take care.